had every intention of doing it. But you know how it is. My cousin, once removed from his family, came over.
Come on.
Wouldn't leave.
Yeah.
You know how you take and get rid of that cousin once removed? Look at him telling him, I'm going to church. You either going home or you're going with me. Choice is yours. I'd really like just pick up that young church.
That's right.
But the choice is yours. Amen. You gotta intend. Listen. God didn't go die on no cross on no wimp. He had an intent. Listen, he prayed to his Father. Father, if it be thy will, let this cup pass me by. He was intended to be a sacrifice. Guess what? He didn't have a third cousin once removed to come by. Ain't you glad?
Amen.
Because he'd have still been sitting with that cousin, you'd have been in hell.
Amen. Very good.
You got to have an intent.
That's right.
Amen. That's good.
Intend to tell everybody you know about God.
Amen.
Intend to tell everybody you know what time church time is. Hey, you even need to intend to go by and pick them up.
Amen.
I took out a little old hamster mobile of mine. Me and my wife has actually been like hamsters in it. So many people call us, well, I don't know. We'll shove you up a tailpipe on the roof. I'll tie you down. Come on, I'll come get you.
Amen.
You won't go to church. You might not want to ride back with me, but I'll make sure you get there.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, brother.
Amen.
Come on, preach.
Then you need to learn to invent ways to get people to church.
Amen.
Look, the devil invents ways to keep them out. Why can't we invent ways to get them in?
Amen.
And I ain't talking about no hot dog or hamburger sandwich.
That's right.
My daddy always said this. If you can get them in your front door with a hot dog, I can lead them out their back with a double cheeseburger.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
When you talk about your church, when you talk about your God, people ought to see something going on in you. They ought to see you rise. Amen. They ought to see you get excited. Guess what? If you want somebody, I'd really like to invite you to church. Sunday. We got a good preacher. We're usually out there about 12:30. So you got plenty of time to go eat. I really would like to see you. Why don't you come see us? You have a good day.
Amen.
You come with me with that junk, I'm going to look at you and tell you. You ain't no more excited than that about church. Why do you think I want to go?
Right. Amen.
Amen. You got a good preacher. You ought to walk up and tell people. Let me tell you what, buddy. You need to come to my church.
Amen.
You need to check out our church.
Amen.
Because guess what? God done turned my preacher into the rocket man. Amen. He's been doing a roadrunner around the church. Don't worry. You won't get bored. You'll be excited the whole time. You just wear a neck brace so you can keep up with him without hurting yourself. We start early in the morning, and we might not get out till late that night. Amen.
Amen.
That's good, preacher.
Amen.
That's good.
People, they go out.
3 hour services.
Have visitation. Here's 90% of the Christians now.
Mm-hmm.
You give me a track.
Here you go, bro.
Oh,
man.
Cocked and loaded.
Ain't nobody here. I mean, I'm standing.
Come in.
Why does a preacher have us do is throw him out. We go out here knocking on his doors, ain't there nobody home?
Yeah.
Door gets slammed in our face. Let him get slammed in his. Me, I'm gonna leave this here.
Yep.
I ain't going back out of town.
Oh yeah.
I'm going home to fix me a double bologna sandwich, deeply fried black, and a bag of chips, and get in the recliner and turn on Who's Sleeping with Jane this week.
Well,
not you, Sister Jane. I pay more Jane Fonda. I love you, Sister. I admire you. You like me, you got a big mouth. You tell somebody in a heartbeat what you got, baby.
Hey!
Amen!
That's why I love you. Hey man, you'll tell them right quick, like, you didn't come here to serve God, you need to hit the door.
Yeah.
Hey.
Where was I at? Okay. All right, listen. I've heard this, boy, Aaron. I've heard this since I started preaching. Well, I don't know why the preacher just won't go to that NIV Bible.
Oh,
it's a whole lot easier to understand. No, it makes it a lot lazier for you.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. The KJV was good enough for my great granny who didn't finish school. She understood it fine. It's good enough for me. Amen. Praise God, far as I'm concerned, there ain't but one Bible. But here's the problem. Here's the problem.
That's good right there. Come on.
Give y'all the problem with the world today. Preacher told me I need to do Bible study. I need to read my word. I'm going to read it. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved and longed for. What in the world does that mean? And longed for. Is he lonely? I didn't know God was lonely. It says it right here. He was longed for.
Yeah, man.
My joy and crown, so shall fast in the Lord, my dear, so shall fast. The Lord's lonely. I'm going to have joy and a crown.
Yep.
And I'm going to get it quickly. My dearly beloved. That's what God said.
Hey.
See, here's the deal. For you young folks, therefore means now go out.
Yeah. Amen.
With all means all of us.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Not just one,
that's
all
right.
Of us.
That's right.
We don't take time anymore to sit down and study God's word.
You're exactly right.
And get into it.
Yep.
And ask God to
reveal it,
visualize it, and reveal it to us.
You're exactly right.
Amen. Oh, you know what? Oh, Lord, have mercy. Praise God. I hope this guy gets saved, and I hope he goes to heaven. If he don't, he's going to burn hell wide open.
Amen.
Yeah. Let me give you, I'm going to sidetrack just 30 seconds. NIV. Now, we're going to ask you a question. Don't lie, remember you in God's house.
Hey,
you lie anywhere else, Don't do it here.
That's right.
Amen. If you do it here, you have no fear or respect. Yeah.
That's right. Amen.
How many people got the NIV?
Holy Grail.
My bad.
You use it?
No.
You use it? You need to throw them in the garbage.
Amen.
And burn them.
It was a gift.
I don't care if it was.
That's right.
But did you know the guy that owns the publishing company of that company is the biggest porn owner in the world?
Yeah.
Listen, I'm just explaining it to everybody. The guy, Harper and Collins Publishing, publishes the NIV. Right along beside it, they publish two other books. One is called The Joys of Gay Sex. The other one is The Satanic Bible. You think I want to read any of that garbage that he's put in the Bible?
That's right.
That ain't nothing but you listen. That ain't nothing but the Satan trying to overcome the world, get everybody confused, and everybody thinking that's God's word. Look, there's chapters, there's verses left out of it. That ain't no Bible. That right there ain't even a good five star.
You're running well, preacher. Right on
time. And then to top it off, the guy that owns the publishing company owns the biggest porn site in the universe.
Oh,
yeah. Uh-huh. Theodore Murdoch.
Yeah.
Amen.
You think I want to read anything he's got? I want to get on his website, but I know I can't get to him because he's got all these highfalutin people that I'll just get in contact with. Yeah. I want to get to him in heaven. Buddy, you didn't know, but you're on your way to hell.
Amen.
And this old redneck preacher right here wants to let you know the best thing you can ever do is show God a little respect. You need to take quick publishing that NIV Bible, that Joy of Safe Sex. Joy of Gay Sex, because let me tell you something, I ain't being graphic, I ain't being nasty. I've been in prison, I ain't seen nobody enjoy gay sex, amen?
Yeah.
Somebody had to be raped for it to happen.
Amen.
And then he wants to produce a Bible for you to worship the devil. How many of you want to go out and buy your NIV? Did you know they're trying to get rid of the KJV?
Yep.
They want nothing but the NIV for you. That's Satan trying to take over.
That's right.
And not let you get with God.
Amen. Praise God.